He was truly an NFL owner unlike any other. It was never just business for Pat Bowlen. The Broncos were indeed family. Anyone who worked, played, or coached for Mr. B cherished the opportunity and knew how fortunate they were.
Bowlen died last night at the age of 75 after a years-long battle with Alzheimer's. Bowlen was just 40 years old when he bought a majority stake in the Broncos back in 1984. That began an incredible run of success. The Broncos went to 3 Super Bowls in 4 years in the 1980s, and in the 90s, history was made when John Elway led the team to back-to-back titles. Bowlen stepped away from the team in 2014 because of his health.
Despite all those victories in the 80s, it was Mike Shanahan in the 90s who, along with John Elway and company, finally brought home those Lombardi trophies. I sat down with Mike Shanahan today as he remembered his former boss and close pal.
For Mike Shanahan, sadness over learning of Pat Bowlen's passing soon gave way to wonderful memories.
I just started thinking about the great times that I had with him and, you know, all the good times.
And they're now part of Broncos legend, like those back-to-back Super Bowl titles.
When the trophy was raised after beating the Packers, you saw Pat with it and the look on his face. How did you feel towards him and just that accomplishment for him personally?
Well, I thought it was so great because when he, this one's for John. I thought that was so special. Number one, because he had such a great relationship with John. He was so sincere. He was so happy for John.
The coach says Pat Bowlen's powerful work ethic was paired with a great sense of humor. Remember that full-length fur coat early on?
I knew he had no idea what was going to happen after that. I'm going, oh, you're going to get killed on this one. He looked at me, he said, what are you talking about? I said, oh, they're going to roast you in Denver. Just get ready for it. But Pat was a guy that could actually laugh at that and, you know, have a relationship, especially being an assistant coach at that time.
And after one Super Bowl win, Shanahan learned not even the president interrupts the famous Bowlen morning workout.
Pat had a situation where the president's going to call him at, you know, 5:15. And Pat says, you got to take the call. I said, Pat, I can't take it. It's the president of the United States. You take the call. You come. He said, no, I can get my workout in. And he got the workout in.
And the coach says all the Broncos' success was built on the owner's fiery competitiveness.
We would kind of run together. And the one thing you would know that when you do run with Pat, that it's competition. So I had to get in shape if I was going to run with him because he would try to hurt you. I mean, not just beat you, hurt you.
The next training camp, the coach was ready.
It's the first time I actually got him tired. So I felt like we had just won the Super Bowl at that time because I didn't think that would ever happen. Yeah.
Says a lot about Pat Bowlen that Mike Shanahan remained a very close friend even after he fired him. Shanahan told me that afterwards they talked every day on the phone as Bowlen told him to focus on the positives as he moved forward.